strap yourself in and join us for the making of Godsmack 5.
I really love recording this way so far because it's just a completely different format from how we're used to working.
I like this a lot because it keeps us all involved. And on the long run, we'll probably be done quicker.
Not only has it given us the reward we were looking for, but it also has been moving a lot quicker.
I think we've done 5 that are done, and I think 6 days, we kick some ass. A song a day we're trying to do.
We have 5 more songs.
Now we're really close to the Oracle, and we're really close to Devil's Swing. Couple touch-ups in Devil's Swing, couple samples in the Oracle, and those two will be done.
But I decided to change the name from Saints and Sinners to the Oracle. And the reason being is because I started really doing a lot of research on Saints and Sinners, and although I liked what it represented, it's been done before. I think Whitesnake had a record out in 82 or something like that, which I wasn't that worried about because that's almost 30 years ago. But there's been some other artists as well, even Spanish albums that I found that were called Saints and Sinners in Spanish. With all that put together, I started rethinking the name. And then with the name Godsmack and then the title being called Saints and Sinners, it was all feeling a little bit religious to me. And that really wasn't what this record represented. Once I wrote the instrumental called The Oracle, we titled it that because it's really the epitome of all rock songs. Like, if you listen to this track, it almost has every transition that's ever been created in rock music in one song. I thought it was just kind of a brilliant little piece, you know? The Oracle became this inner joke in the band as we were writing and, you know, coming up with something else, and Dave would be like, bro, put the Oracle guitar on, because when you play that guitar, just oracly things happen, and, you know, greatness comes out of it, and whatever.
Last one right here.
That's it. Never.
That's the end of it?
Never again, dude.
It's over.
We're ordering food. Do you want food?
Mm-hmm. Always.
Yeah. Always. I know, I don't need to ask you that.
It's a little bit smaller every day.
That's good. Oh, look at the dent almost. You got to get the dent to go away. You have 2 layers here. Like, this was. Look at. Hold
hey,
the shit.
That's fucking
shit
rest on my belt, dude.
Let me show you something. I know
Let
you
me
can't
show you something.
You can't see as well as I can, but no, seriously. This was the old Dave a long time ago, like in high school. And this next, like, layer that came out.
It's the new and improved me.
Ready?
You know how much fun it was making that?
The healthiest I've ever been in my life. Fucking banana. No thanks. Nice try. See you in another year.
Oh, shit.
They did 4.
I'm afraid I'll shit myself. Wheatgrass, baby. The ultimate blood cleanser.
Come on, really? We're gonna do 4? You doing 4?
There was a time we used to do shots of Crown Royal and fucking heroin.
Yeah.
Now we're fucking doing wheatgrass juice. Because half of our colons are hanging out of our ass.
It's the gym toast. Gym toast.
As I thought about the title of the record being The Oracle, it really made sense because, you know, we really feel that there's just, it is our piece of art. It is our everything right now.
What do you think of this beat if it was like, he's playing
same spot. Right in the fucking front.
Yeah, we gotta get this thing grooving, happy and fucking badass.
That's good.
Good, I'm the star.
The beat I was just hearing too, you know how you're playing, like, play the bone, do bang, that, got the dad of that bone, go bang, play that for me? Let's hear that with the band. I think it'll sound killer.
War and Peace, man. War and Peace and Crying Like a Bitch are probably two of the toughest songs on this record. Just playing it even instrumentally, like, fuck, this song just rocks. It's just a big, fat, killer, sick, tough riff. It's the angel on one shoulder and the devil on the other shoulder. It's wanting to do right, wanting to be that person that you image yourself to be, but always having the temptations in front of you, always having these little fruits that dabble and that you wanna, you know it's the dark side over there and you can't help but wanting to pursue it a little bit and research it and, you know, find out what's going on, and usually that leads to trouble. I love the transition that goes from the second chorus into the bridge section in the middle of the song. There's two things that really, you know, make my hair stand up on my arms about that part, and it's that simple snare roll, big, powerful, boom, 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 and then it goes into this just sick cut time groove, and I was just like, I will fucking jump off the stage again for that kind of shit.
Get them cameras rolling right now.
I'm calling me out, kid.
Will not be a slob.
I need sugar.